the dam removal here at this site is critically important to the city, not only from an ecological perspective and an environmental perspective, but from a community perspective as well. We've been working closely with the state for a better part of a decade now on this project. It's one where I think we see the finish line on the horizon.
It's pretty weird owning a dam, actually. I don't have any friends who own dams. We're the only guys who I know who own a dam. I remember when we were a kid going to look at it and being in awe of the power of the water going over it. It is a very active section of the river here. And you know, you can understand why at one point it was a really valued resource for industry here.
The west branch of the Housatonic River historically had been very important for manufacturing in the city. Of course, the need for water power generation in these mill buildings has long since passed. Dams are now just old relics in the ecosystem. They serve no useful purpose, and in fact, they're harming the river with each passing day. You know, the ecosystem is compromised.
I grew up in Pittsfield back when the Housatonic River was heavily polluted. The really big shift was the Clean Water Act that stopped all the sewage from all the paper mills going into the river and stopped all the oil and gas going into the river, which I think is the major thing that allowed wildlife to come back to it.
We've been involved in the river cleanups and helped haul, you know, hundreds of pounds of junk out of this thing. It's actually a really pretty river. It's an amazing thing to have running through here, and we're really excited to be part of this process.
We recognize that these dams had a very valuable role in Pittsfield's past, but now we're sort of turning the page on a new history, one that respects and responds to environmental concerns.
I think it became more prevalent to our lives when the discussion started about removing it. Then it became like, okay, this is a project that could happen. The dam is 100 years old. At some point, you would have to replace it or take it down anyway. It's not something that's going to be here for another 100 years, no matter how you feel about it.
This sort of area where you've got great tree cover and the water is cooler and really supports a diverse community of life isn't what people get to see. Instead, they see the area more above the dam up to the bridge where it's sort of backed up and sluggish and really not so attractive.
There's an unhealthy draw to the dam, and there's a trestle that is looming over it like this big iron cloud. And it's not a productive, positive piece of Pittsfield now. It's the opposite. It's dangerous. People have gotten hurt there. It's an urgent thing for Pittsfield to turn this area into something more productive.
A few years ago, there was a gentleman who lost his life. He was swimming here, and that ended tragically. This is a dark, hidden spot in our city. It's one that we need to shine a light on. We need to remove the public nuisance that is this failing dam.
It seems to me it's inevitable that it comes down, and the sooner the better.
More and more people are getting back to the river. There certainly is more canoeing. There's now a canoe launch on the West Branch from Wakona Stadium. You can canoe on down. So I'm really looking forward to having this dam removed and envision a great floodplain forest on either side. I think it's going to be great.